What do you think about AI agents? Do you think they will also help with this kind of use cases? Because one of the things we are experimenting a lot, that agents that can go online, search missing data, and just provide you everything. Because one of the biggest problems for even e-commerce is to find information to fill into the database, to enrich it and personalize to users.
Agents are the next step in human-machine interfaces. Today, we're interacting with all sorts of websites directly, and there's a lot of actual human time and knowledge that's required in order to even do something like go shopping. You have to know which sites to go to and so on. Instead, we're going to have custom agents that will have knowledge as to what our different payment methods are, coupons, which sites to find different products for, and they'll do the shopping for us. They'll be able to anticipate what we need, so we don't need to tell it every time we want to go to the store. And there's going to be seller agents as well, and a whole ecosystem between the sell side agent and the buy side agent. And there'll be actual social norms that end up on the internet. And this is not 10 years out. This is just, I mean, it's actually happening today in the B2B space, and it's going to be very common in just a year or two.
So you think in the future, B2B agents will be negotiating terms together, like AI agents, just exchange emails on pricing and quantities and quality and everything, and then you just get an email that contract is ready to be signed?
I 100% believe that that is going to be happening. You'll have negotiations happen on both sides. And what's interesting is that there will also be more sophisticated and bulk negotiations where your buyer agent will know that, okay, well, I need this now, but I'm going to need something else in the future and so on, and can negotiate bundles of purchases and timings for deliveries and so forth that would be really too sophisticated for us as individuals to negotiate. And the sell side agent will do the same thing. And all of that will tie into inventory on the sell side, and they'll be able to have predictive analytics to provide even, you know, better inventory, and it's going to become critical for just-in-time delivery to have last-mile inventory, micro warehouses, and the only way you can pull that off is with sell-side agents.
Ari, you mentioned that this kind of agent will be able to do shopping on different websites. Is it a risk for lots of e-commerce founders that some big players like Google could build a product that will just eliminate all e-commerce websites or like Amazon? And if it's not in their website, they will just buy it for you on somewhere else.
Yeah, it is going to be a risk. And between now and then, a couple of things that we need to be aware of. First of all, your site itself needs to be agent friendly. The easiest way to do that is actually to just follow the accessibility guidelines, like the American Disability Act and so forth, to ensure that you have the appropriate metadata with schema.org and annotations for images and so forth, so that a blind person could access your site. That will allow Google to index it better. So today you'll have better SEO, but also for agents to be able to more easily navigate your own site. Ultimately, you do have this risk of things consolidating. And this is not unrelated to what's happened in the D2C, direct-to-consumer area, where B2B businesses are knocking out distributors and selling direct to their endpoints rather than indirectly through a distributor. And if you have a mega sales agent like Amazon and everyone just becomes D2C, then we as individuals need to start thinking in terms of where we want to work. You really want to work at the beginning of the chain in the manufacturing side of the world rather than in the middleman part where it becomes automated and potentially consolidated with a couple of major players.